one seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere.
bless his holy name. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Eternal God, our Father, our Creator, our Redeemer, and our Sustainer, anoint thy servant from on high to preach your holy, unadulterated gospel, that lost souls may be saved, that saved souls may be inspired to stay on the battlefield for thee. Prepare the hearts and minds of these thy people to hear, to receive, and to become doers of thy preached word. In the name of Jesus, hear our prayer and accept our petition. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray and give thanks. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. 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 Bless his holy name. Bless his holy name. If you can get excited about the birth of our Lord Jesus, something's wrong with you. If you can't get excited about the fact that he was born in Bethlehem, something is wrong with you. If you can't get excited about sweet little Jesus boy, then something is wrong with you. If you can't get excited, because if he had never been born, if he had never lived, if he had never died, if he had never got up with all power in his hand, we would not have a right to the tree of life. So I bless his name. I glorify him. I magnify him. He's worthy to be praised. I wish I had about 5 or 6 worshipers in here that knows he's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Anybody know he's worthy? Anybody know what he's done for you in 2018? Our year of favor? He's worthy, I tell you. I magnify him. I glorify him. Bless his name. Thank you. Thank you. Sometimes you just have to let go and let God have his way. Sometimes you don't have to worry about the weave, the heels, the wig, the girdle, the too tight pants, the too tight shoes. Just kick them off. Let God have his way. Brothers, you ain't got to be all macho. Brothers, you ain't got to be all stiff. Help me, Holy Ghost. Sometimes, brothers, it's all right to get ugly for the Lord. Sometimes, brothers, it's all right to cry for the Lord. Because real men cry. Real men wear pink. Help me, Holy Ghost. Real men can show compassion. Because Jesus was a loving and is a loving God who shows compassion. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Darius. Thank you for blessing us. The Lord used you, Mike, in a powerful way. The anointing was upon you. And I thank God for you yielding to the anointing. For the next little while, I want to call your attention to the gospel according to St. Luke, the 2nd chapter. And I actually want to start at the 7th verse instead of verse 8. I was going to do verse 8 through 14, but I think I want to start at verse number 7. If you don't have it on screen, that's fine. We'll read it. But if I'm going to read it from the King James Version today. I like the way the King James reads. The Gospel according to St. Luke. And if you can please stand wherever you are in the sanctuary. If you're able to stand, Please stand for the reading of God's word. The gospel according to St. Luke chapter 2, beginning with verse number 7, and we will climax at verse number 14. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And they were in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. I want to talk this morning from the subject, our Savior is born. Our Savior is born. As we celebrate our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ's birth on this coming Tuesday, we pause now on this day to reflect and to give thanks to God for giving us the greatest gift. These four Sundays during the Advent season have encompassed the time in which we anxiously have awaited to prepare ourselves for the celebration of his birth. Each Sunday, we've tried to prepare you for this great moment, this great day, this great occasion in which we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. The first two Sundays of Advent, I preached. Last Sunday, Reverend Moorhead preached. Today, I climax Advent by finishing the Advent message, but also proclaiming the Christmas message, because the day is now here in which we celebrate. The waiting is now over. The preparations are now complete. We've come to celebrate and to rejoice because over 2,000 years ago, our Savior was born. And so we're here today for one purpose and one purpose only, and that is to praise our God for giving us a Savior, his only begotten Son. As we look briefly at the text for the morning, we see Dr. Luke giving his account of Jesus' birth. After Luke reveals that Jesus had been born in a stable and laid in a manger because there was no room in the inn, he goes on to note and to write that there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Notice that he said that there were shepherds abiding in the field. Abiding means living in the field. A shepherd is genuinely concerned about his flock, so much so that he would live in the outdoors, live outside in the fields to be with his flock. Let me say that's the way that Palestinian shepherds lived. They cared for the flock, whether it was a flock of the sheep or whatever, they looked after their flock. May I add today that in the same tradition, under shepherds, help me somebody, shepherds of God's flock, we also love our flock and are willing to do whatever we can to protect you and to lay down our lives for you. The record said that a shepherd also keeps watch over the flock at night. This is to guard them against the thieves and predatory animals that will come to try to bring harm against the little innocent sheep. So a shepherd really cannot sleep because he is watching over the flock by night and protecting them from would-be attackers and protecting them from the animals that will come to do them harm. Likewise, the flocks reserved for the temple sacrifice were also kept in the fields near Bethlehem of Judea. They were kept there throughout the year, and so a shepherd sometimes had to stay out in the cold, even in the winter time, to effectively guard his flock. When I think about these shepherds, I can't help but think about the love that I have for each of you as a shepherd. I can't help but think about the fact that God has blessed me to be your shepherd for 23 years. And some say, well, Pastor, do you get tired of this? Do you get tired of that? Yes, we get tired physically from the journey, but I got news for you. A true shepherd never gets tired of praying for and watching over the flocks by day and by night. Well, lest I hold you too long, while out in the fields, help me somebody, keeping watch over their flock by night, the record said that an angel of the Lord appeared unto these shepherds. It said they were terrified and scared to death. The angel more than likely was Gabriel, because that is the one that appears to Zechariah in the temple. Gabriel is the only angel that we've heard known by name that appears in these birth narratives about the virgin birth of Jesus. It was Gabriel that appeared to Zechariah. It was Gabriel that appeared to Mary. And now we believe it is also Gabriel who appears to these shepherds while they were keeping watch over their flock by night. The record said that they responded with fear. That is a most appropriate, help me somebody, response. And if you were to see an angel, you would also be afraid because you did not know what was going on. Angels would come to give messages from God. But when an angel came, you knew it was an angel because there was always the presence of the Holy with God, with the angel himself. And you knew you were in the presence of God Almighty. The angels told the shepherds, do not be afraid, fear not, for I have brought you news of great joy. I brought you encouragement. I brought you news that shall be of great joy to all people. I know some of the shepherds were wondering, what news could this be? What news could this angel Gabriel give to them that shall be good and great for all people? I know many of you probably asked the same question today. What is it that the angel told these shepherds? What is it that he said that would be good for everyone? Was it the fact that Santa Claus is coming to town? Was it the fact that you're gonna have a lot of gifts under your Christmas tree because you've been nice and not naughty? What was it that the angel told them that would be a great news to all people? Did he tell them that you're gonna have a big fat raise on your job when you get back to work? Did he tell them that you will get the big boo that you wanted? Help me somebody, to be the man or the woman of your dream. What exactly did the angel Gabriel tell them? Well, I got news for you. Was not about Santa Claus, wasn't about Rudolph, Dasher, Dancer, was not about getting your boo, was not about all the gifts under the tree. But the angel said, this day in the city of David, in Bethlehem, help me somebody, a Savior has been born. He is Jesus the Christ, who is known as the Lord. That ought to be shouting news for somebody, because he said, this day in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord, has been born. Notice that the angel has to spell out exactly who the Savior is. He didn't just say the Savior has been born, but he had to explain it because many Jews were looking for a political leader to deliver them or save them from Roman authority. Others were looking for and hoping for a Savior who would deliver them from sickness and physical handicap and disability. So when the angel Gabriel announces that there is a Savior who has been born, it is someone that is far greater than any political leader. He says there is a Savior that's been born who is far greater, help me, Holy Ghost, than someone that can even heal your body. a Savior has been born who is far superior than anyone else that you think can do something for you. This Savior is the Christ. He is the Messiah. He's the anointed one. He is the Holy One. He is the one who will deliver you from sin and from death. And let me add also, he is Christ the Lord. That is good news because the shepherds were not expecting that kind of message. But I got news for you. When they started talking about Jesus being the Christ, being the anointed one, being the Holy One, that let them know that he was the Messiah. But then they went on further and said, he will save you from your sin. He will save you from sin and from death. That gave us the understanding that Jesus is not just a political leader who they thought was coming. He's not the one that's the spiritual healer, but he's the one that heals us from our sins. And that is what gives us great news today. Why? Because all of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All of us were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. All of us have messed up and have made mistakes in life. All of us need a Savior, help me somebody, to deliver us from our waywardness and from our sin. What is this thing called sin? I'm so glad that you asked. In the Greek, it comes from the word harmatia, which means to err or to do wrong or to disobey. It means to turn away from God and to turn towards sin. It means to turn towards doing things your own way. I know Frank Sinatra had that song, I Did It My Way. But I got news for you. If you do it your way will get you in trouble every time. I believe we ought to start trying to do it God's way. Because if I do it my way, help me somebody, I'll mess things up. If I do it my way, I will make sure that things are not the way that God has called them to be. But I want to do things God's way. And I want to say today that I thank and praise God that I got a Savior in the world today who has delivered me from my sin and from spiritual death. Does that mean that I will stop sinning all the time? No. But it just means that I have been delivered and saved from a lifestyle of sin as opposed to the one that I used to live. Help me somebody. That means that I will still mess up. I'll still make mistakes, but I got a God who loves me. I got a God who will forgive me. And I got a God who will have mercy upon me. And so I thank and praise God today that that title, He is Christ the Lord. Lord was a designation originally reserved only for God Almighty. But to now assign the Lord's title to Jesus the Christ lets us know that Jesus also is the one who is Christ the Lord. He is the one that will save us from all of our sins. Well, my brothers and my sisters, as we now prepare to bring the message to a close. Y'all say, what do you mean, Pastor? It's only 11:13. You surely cannot be trying to bring the message to a close. Well, I got news for you. Oh, yes, I am. Help me somebody. I don't have to stand here all day and tell you about the good news of Jesus because I think you've already heard the story. My message today and my task today is just to reiterate what you already know and to get you out of here where you can finish your Christmas shopping and prepare for your Christmas dinner. So as the narrative concludes, Gabriel tells the shepherds where they will find the baby Jesus. He said that you will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes. He said, this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. He gave specific instruction as to where they would find baby Jesus. All of a sudden it said there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host. They were praising God and saying glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards men. I don't know about you, but I thank God today that the heavenly host had to give God the praise and the glory. I thank God today that they had to give the angel Gabriel the high fives, and they gave Gabriel the hallelujahs, and they gave Gabriel the shouts of praise and joy. They said, glory to God in the highest. In other words, glory to God up in heaven. And then on earth, let there be peace and goodwill towards all men. You may ask the question, well, Brother Pastor, what does this mean for me in 2018? How can I get, or what can I get from this Christmas story? Well, first of all, I want to tell you that we get a sense of commitment and responsibility from the shepherds. How do I know they were committed and they had responsibility? They watched over their flock by night. They protected them from danger seen and unseen danger. That means that we need to have a sense of commitment and responsibility in our lives. Second of all, you can get comfort and you can get hope from the angel Gabriel. The angel said, fear not, for I bring you good tidings of great joy. In other words, I came to give you comfort and I came to give you hope. But last of all, you can get the good news that we now have a Savior and his name is Jesus. I praise his holy name because his name is Jesus and he will save us from our sins. So on this day that we celebrate our Lord and Savior's birth, do not be afraid of anything that comes your way, for we have a Savior that can solve anything. I know that there is a government shutdown. I know there is a madman in the White House, but I got news for you. There's still a Savior who has not forgotten his people. There's still a Savior that knows how to trump, ain't he all right? I thank God today that we have a Savior who came to give life and came to give deliverance. He came to deliver us from our sins and from destruction and from spiritual death. Don't look for a political leader because they will only tell more lies. But hold on to God's unchanging hand. Don't look for one who can take care of just about it, but can't do anything for the soul. But there is one whose name is Jesus, who can save you from your sins. Ain't he all right? I said, ain't he all right? I thank God for a man called Jesus. We celebrate that our Savior is born, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. His name shall be called Emmanuel, God with us. Ain't he all right? I said, ain't he all right? His name shall be called Jesus, because he's the Savior of the world. The name of Jesus is so sweet. I love his music to repeat. Makes my joy full and complete. The precious name of Jesus. I love the name of him whose heart knows all my griefs and bears a part, who bids all anxious fears depart. I love the name of Jesus. Jesus, oh how sweet the name. Jesus, every day the same. Jesus, let all saints proclaim his worthy praise forevermore. That name I fondly love to hear. It never fails my heart to cheer. It mutes its desire, the fallen ear. Exalt up the name of Jesus. No word of man can ever tell how sweet the name that I love so well. Oh, let his praises swell. I love the name of Jesus. Jesus, oh, how sweet the name. Jesus, every day the same. Jesus, let all saints proclaim his worthy praise forevermore. Is there anybody here that loves the name of Jesus? Is there anybody here that can call on Jesus in the midnight hour? Won't he make a way out of no way? Won't he dry your tears? Say yeah, I know he's all right. Say yeah, hey, I know he's all right. Oh yeah, we've come to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Our Savior is born.